Hey guys, welcome back to Weld.com. I'm your guest host, Brian Logaglio. We're here at Marchman Technical College. We're gonna go through a open bud MIG weld root. MIG rut. We're gonna do some MIG ruttins. That sounds dirty. I'm not doing any MIG ruttins on camera. We're gonna run a open butt MIG root procedure. This is what I run my students through prior to putting them on pipe. Let's get in it. So this is my fit up. It's around 37 and a half degrees. Really, it's more like 35 degree bevel. This is ASME prep. You can use this procedure, or you can see this, at least it's fit up in this bevel procedure for B31-1 or B31-3. But either way, I'm sitting about, 32nd over an eighth. When you're running a MIG root, you want a little bit more of a gap opening. The root face is a knife edge. You know, helps you penetrate the molds.
Okay.
All right, guys. Today we're using the Everlast Cyclone 200E. We're gonna run 19 volts, 340 inches. If I need to make a change, I will. But I'm pretty confident in those numbers. We'll see if she slaps. So when I'm starting, first thing is you're gonna have to come off a tack, and they need to be bridge tacks. You don't wanna try to tie in or limit your tie-ins to a tack prior, and that's just been my experience. Every time I've done this procedure, I've tried to bridge tack it. But once you start on and once you build that bridge across your bevel to bevel, you wanna stay on the leading edge of your puddle. You'll start, if it starts kind of blowing open, you're just on the too far of the leading edge, or you've outrun your puddle, so you step back into the leading edge of your puddle. And this is with hardwire MIG in the short arc process. I'm not talking about like RDM or anything like that. That's another technique, but on this one, on a short arc hardwire MIG root going downhill, you want to stay on the leading edge and only weave it if you have to. You wanna stay right in the middle and feed that puddle, and you'll get external or internal reinforcement, internal on pipe, external on plate. If it starts popping and you start outrunning your puddle, you need to just step up a little bit higher. Most of the time, if you outrun it just barely, you can barely tell if you recover quickly. Worst case scenario, you're gonna have a whisker push through. If you feel like you shot some wire on the inside, you need to stop and grind it out at that point. and make yourself elongated ramp to make that tie-in on your the retie on your route to restart it. So that's how I do a downhill MIG route. It translates from plate to pipe, you know. But this is a learning tool that gets you to pipe. I hope this helps a young person. If you guys have any questions, you can follow me on Instagram, ask me directly on Bingo Welding. That little Cyclone runs pretty good. Able to put a root on 3/8 plate. Next time, make every weld better than your last. I'm not supposed to say that one.